I read a study yesterday. It said that last year, more than half of us actually chose not to take our full vacations from our jobs. Question. Don't you think it's crazy that so many of us go into work even when we don't need to be there? Times we could be on the beach buried in sand or traveling the earth. We spend it in the office, traveling from desk to desk, buried in paperwork. See, in this chaotic world, everything goes so fast. We're so busy, seems like everyone's middle name is multitask. But now before you go and act all holier than thou, how many extra tabs do you have open on your computer right now? See, we all need time to get away from the race, for our family, friends, for the sake of our mental state. Time to rewind, recharge, and reconnect. Not reporting to the office on emails that should be on redirect. Because life, ladies and gentlemen, is all about moments. No one in history has ever been able to hold on to one. Not a single soul. And you never get them back. See? There one goes. No do-over, no rewind, no DVD root menu to skip to a previous scene. Ask yourself, how many trips did you almost take? How many sights have you almost seen? How many moments have you lost thinking about the next one? Thinking that once you get this or get there, maybe that will be the best one. Life has taught me that all we will ever have is now. But let me be perfectly clear. I'm not saying to quit your job. Even though I know you deserve a 6-month vacation twice a year. But how about small steps, short trips, with long dances, no distractions. Spend time with family instead of coworkers. Meditation instead of aggravation. Replace our screensavers with sunrises.
Yo, you believe when they say we ain't shit, we can't grow? All we are is dope dealers and gangsters and hoes. And you believe when they be telling you lie? All on the media, they make the world look crazy to keep you inside. Why you listen when the teachers at school know you a young single parent out struggling? They think you a fool. Give your kids bad grades and put them in dumber classes. Killing shorty future, I wonder how do we last it? Underground in a casket, ancestors turning. I'm learning something every day, there is no Lazarus. Words like God is Greek or Latin. So if you study Egypt, you'll see the truth written by the masters. My niggas is chilling, getting high, relaxing, envisioning ownership. Yeah, it can happen. What do we own? Not enough land, not enough homes, not enough banks to give my brother a loan. What do we own? The skin on our backs. We rent and we ask for reparations. Then they hit us with tax and insurance if we live to be old. What about now? So stop being controlled. We black zombies.
Walking, talking dead, though we think we're living.
Black zombies.
We just copycat, following the system.
Black zombies.
Walking, talking dead, though we think we're living.
Black zombies.
We just copycat, following the system.
Black zombies. Hey yo, we trapped in our own brain. Fuck behind bars, we've already gone insane. They've already gave up, cut our own heads off. Stab our own backs and dream too much without fulfilling reality. Too greedy in, can't have one or two chains, we need three of them. Can't have one or two guns without squeezing them on our own people. And fuck black leaders, cause whites ain't got none leading them. The rhythm is cosmic, Nas is divinity, the deity's prophet. Let's all get down and get up. Victims walking around with Down syndrome, all stuff.
But that's the whole tragic point, my friends. What would I do if I could suddenly feel and to know once again that what I feel is real? I could cry, I could smile, I might lay back for a while. Tell me what would I do if I could feel?
I was young, I was surviving the times, waiting for my moment, I was destined to shine. Lil Ray had an NXX, I was hoping I'm next, wanting bracelets, never had a rope on my neck, unless I was holding tie a chain, rest in peace. Even though that night you flipped on us, you warned us, if you came back and we still on the corners, we goners. Moving on to move your
where they said shorty rhyme. Tragedy, he used to come through all the time. I'm talking Juice Crew, not what the world defined. He had a sister named Aaron, for sure was fine. That was my first crush, I bought my first mic. I wrote my first verse, I was about 9. I was about my fantasized house buying. Met Paul, he wore some big glasses. Him and Mel Kwan took me where G-Rap lived. I was happy just getting some answers. I ain't even know what a record advance was. I'm seeing whole sex in the studio bathrooms with rap dudes thinking, wow, she moved me. Same girl then, right now's a groupie. Back then, she was like the star in the movie. Large jewelry and expensive Gucci. Next stop, paid in full, posse recruits me. Knew they were some millionaires, they ropes were dookie. Every B man looking like touchy, shoot me. You see, every time Rob didn't show, I get to record demos at attempts to blow. I wonder, could they tell? How did they know? 16 years later, here I go. Trying to get us a deal. G-Rap trying to get us to sign the co-chill. But Fly Todd didn't have the contract we wanted. Clark Kent just signed us, he didn't want us. Russell said I sounded like G, the nigga fronted. Reef and Matty C offered me a little money. Shit a little funny, feel a little laughter. Rebel of hip-hop, coming through a white rapper. My boy MC Search nevertheless took me to Columbia, back then CBS. Chris Schwartz, Rough House, he was the best man. I'm bugging cause the label had just dropped Def Jam. Could you picture Russell needing a check, man? But he's smart, he plotted a plan for PolyGram. Life is ill, again life's a movie. Then the roster, Cypress Hill, Nas and Fugees. Before I sold records, no promotion. The rap world like, what's all this commotion? Went plat, mad battles, I'm toasting. 2020 hindsight, for how did they know then?